The problem with having such a vast background is that people don't know how to place you. They want to really narrow it down and label you. So I've learned lately not even to say where I'm from. When people ask me, I'll look at the character, and if she's Latina, I'll say Guatemala. And that will help me get the part. Because if I say, but I grew up in Morocco and Egypt and Connecticut, it gets lost. The great thing about primetime television is they do have a budget. So you frequently get a trailer, and you get, you know, craft services, and there's lunch break, and there's a second AD who's making sure you're okay and taking you around. So, and it's also sort of a well-oiled machine. Like, you become aware of this entity that this television show is, and who runs what, and the delineations between all the different crew members and stuff. On a independent film, an actor might actually help move a prop, you know, that kind of thing. Would never happen on primetime. Just would be against the rules. So the difference is that it's a little bit more luxurious, actually, to work on.
But it's not. It's probably not the pressure of doing TV regular either, because
yeah,
it's
no,
because kind of like
you'd be learning lines all the time. Yeah. It is so wonderful to get to the immediate gratification of stage. You know if the audience is with you or not, usually. You know if they're listening or not. And if it's comedy, you know if they're find you funny or not because they laugh.
Yeah.
So that's wonderful. And you're all taking this leap of faith together. Like, we're all going to pretend that this is real. You're not there. I'm living in this world. And you're just watching me, but you're not really there. I mean, there's just something wonderful about the whole community of it. Going, okay, tell us a story, and we'll listen. But I love film as well because it's so collaborative frequently with the director. As soon as you do the take, he'll talk to you some more and talk to the other actors, and it's like a constant fun rehearsal, and they're just going to use the best rehearsal as the final take. So that's cool because it's constantly creative, if you're lucky, if you get a director who wants to work that way and isn't just a say your line and go kind of person.
And what happens on stage when you're like, oh shit, I can't remember, or
you rely on your other actors and on your improvisational spirit. And frequently the best shows, the best moments are the mistakes, because everybody comes completely alive, you're all alert, and you have to take care of the problem. So if you've been stiff at all or feeling a little rote about it, that gets completely pushed aside because you have to fix the problem. I do feel like whenever I look at the descriptions of roles that are out there, they tend to be monoracial and very specific. So, but I think there's hope, you know. There's always the open ethnicity ones for the person who's playing the flight attendant or whatever, and I just want to work in feature films, studio features at some point soon.
Yeah. So when people see you, what do they typically think you are ethnic-wise?
They have no idea.
Everybody
kind of, I shouldn't say that, it depends. Lately I've been getting Caucasian a lot more than I ever did as a kid.
Until they see your last name and then they're like,
right, did I marry a Chinese person or whatever. Latinos can tell I'm Latin usually, because they know that we look every possible way, but if you have dark hair and dark eyes, you're maybe a little bit more likely. And then I'll frequently get people saying, are you Asian? Yes, Chinese. I'm like, oh yeah, I could tell. I'm like, yep, you could tell. I've written bits and pieces from every single place I've lived. You know, like the foremost thing that I have in my mind whenever I think of that place, the foremost experience. And then I've got to flesh them out and pull them together. And I found myself in the last 10 years telling people stories and them saying, you have to do a show about this. You have to do a show about this. Because I would tell a story about being in Egypt, you know, as a teenager, or being in Panama as a kid, and then coming to Connecticut and the culture shock and all. And they'd be like, you know, I haven't read this. I haven't seen this. I haven't heard this story before. You should do a show or write a book. And since I'm an actor, I thought, well, maybe I should do a show. And I've seen enough one woman and one man shows that I've liked, that I can see how it's possible to do it. I've seen people tell the story of their life without being Well, I've seen both kinds, but I've seen the good ones that are not self-indulgent and are very funny and very moving and move like a bullet and are over, and you're sort of shocked that they're over and it's been an hour, 20 minutes, but you haven't felt it. So that's my goal.
Yeah. Is 2011 the year that Unpacked is going to be unpacked?
Well, it's definitely 10 minutes of it is going to be performed at Wesleyan, my alma mater, in May. So that means I've got to have 10 full ready, audience ready minutes by May. And then I'm hoping that I'll have more than that by May.
So anything else coming up in 2011 thus far besides your one-woman show?
The only other thing I can think of is that I might be having an essay published in an anthology about people who've lived around the world in non-passport countries. And I'll let you know if that,
awesome,
that gets published.
Yeah.
That's nice. I'm an actor, but I'm happy to be a published writer as well.
Exactly.